These stunts you're about to see are dangerous. They were done by trained professionals in secure environments. Don't attempt any of these stunts any place, anywhere, or at any time. Welcome to Dying Extreme, the show that gives you a look into extreme lifestyles. Hang on to your seats and prepare to go for the ride of a lifetime. Dying Extreme is an exciting new show full of action-packed, edge-of-your-seat excitement from start to finish. And it's hosted by Jim Duffner. Dying Extreme is a show that has people spinning their wheels and doing backflips to watch. Welcome to Dying Extreme. My name's Jim Duffner, and I'm going to be your host for the next 30 minutes. Dying Extreme is an exciting new show that takes you behind the scenes, up close and personal, into the lifestyles of the extreme. Today we've got an exciting show for you. We're going to hook up with two of the hottest, fastest young motorcycle racers on the West Coast. And neither one of them are over 15 years old. But first, we're going to show you some of the action that we have coming up on future shows. So hang on to your seats and prepare to go for the ride of a lifetime with Eye on Extreme, the show that keeps its eye on the extreme. Now it's time for an iNews update on 17-year-old racing dynamo Nicole Chezza and last year's Rookie of the Year, Jarrett Mees.
I'm Nicole Chezza, and after Daytona, my crash, I took a few weeks off, let my arm heal up. We went over to American Super Camp after I got my cast off, and that went really well. You know, had a good time, as I always do. Me and Jarrett Mees went over there.
This year went very well. It went better than expected, actually. We had two goals in the beginning of the year this year, and one of them was to win my first Grand National and to finish the points in the top five. And, you know, we finished the points in fourth place this year, so we achieved the top five goal.
And after American Super Camp, we hit the few races, and things went pretty good, you know, still getting used to the Harley. I didn't make any mains yet, but I'm still working on it and getting used to the bike, and I'm starting to feel pretty good on it.
And not only did we win my first national, but we won two nationals this year. First one was at Lima, Ohio, round six, and round 12 of the Quality Check Certified Pre-Owned 4 Championship at Sedalia, Missouri. Both of them were dream come true. I think Lima and Sedalia were very special to me because of Will Davis. Will Davis won his first Grand National ever at Lima as well. And what was really cool, I mean, it was really surprising winning my first national at Lima just because I grew up on Slippery Little Groove short tracks and Slippery Little Groove half miles and never really got any experience with any cushion. And since I rode for Johnny Goad, he made me a really good cushion rider. You know, to win Lima, Ohio was just very special. And, you know, it was a surprise to everybody as well, because I was never a cushion rider, and that was a surprise for Will Davis back in the day too, when he won his first national to on a cushion as well. So then we come to Sedalia, and Sedalia is where Will got killed in turns 3 and 4. And the night before the race, Friday night, I called Mike Hacker, who's been injured this year, and was just talking to him. I was really nervous feeling that night and couldn't fall asleep. And Hacker said, "Man, Will's gonna ride it with you. He's gonna do it with you." And right before the main event, I was on the front row, won my heat race, was second fast time. Right before the main event, I got a Godspeed Will Davis sticker and stuck it on the back of my seat and looked over at Sarah Goad, and said he's going to win this thing with me. He's going to ride on the back. And sure enough, we whole shot it and let every lap, except for the last lap, go into turn one. Brian Smith passed me, and then I repassed him and brought home my second national victory this year. And I put all the credit towards Will Davis because I really think he was up there. He was up there with me.
I went to Syracuse, New York, and felt real good. I decided to ride Pat Maroney's bike. His bike felt a little bit better than mine, and things were going good. I was probably about fifth in my heat race, and the third lap into it, I had a crash and went under the air fence, and let's just say I'm glad that the air fence was there. Otherwise, I might be in a lot worse shape than I ended up. I hit the wall. I slid under the air fence, hit the wall with my head, and had three compressed vertebrae in my back, T2, T3, and T4. But now things are starting to go pretty good. I feel a lot better, a little sore at times, but besides that, everything's going real good. I went to Springfield, Illinois, and almost made the main event there. Had a little couple of rookie mistakes, but besides that, you know, learning is part of the game, I guess. And I'm ready for Des Moines. That'll be the last race of the season in October 1st.
We didn't mean to bother you.
Fast Eddie Mulder is a former racer and the top promoter on the West Coast.
We're out here at Bakersfield, California, Eddie Mulder Race, and so far I really like how he runs his program. It's a pretty narrow, pretty short little short track, so it'll be a lot of bumping and grinding, but it'll be fun. You know, it's season's pretty much over for me. We have one more race left in Des Moines next weekend, and the best I can finish is fourth, and the worst I can finish is fourth, so I finished fourth this year. So I'm pretty proud of myself. I mean, we were in third with 8 points out of second there at one time, and we had a bad deal at Springfield a couple weeks ago, but that's racing. We're still young, and got a lot of things for next year that could happen. AMA's really looking like they're going to do something to support all of us and go the right direction. So I'm really looking forward to next year already, and more or less just want to relax and have some fun at these little short tracks and, you know, make some people happy.
So where are you today?
I'm in California, Bakersfield, California, watching Jeremy's race and just trying to help him out as much as I can.
So how's he looking?
He definitely looks really good. There's a lot of fast guys out here, you know, that we don't ever get to race with. So it's kind of cool coming out here with the local guys and watching them. And I think he's going to do good tonight if he gets off the line good.
Today we're in Bakersfield, California at Eddie Mulder's dirt track race with two of the brightest stars on the West Coast, Lauren Wallace and Stevie Bonzi.
Hi, my name is Lauren Wallace.
My name is Stevie Bonzi. I'm 15 years old. I live in Salinas, California. I've been racing for about 10 years.
In Lauren's first heat race, she got the whole shot and led from start to finish. Stevie had to work his way up through traffic, which he did for the win. Jam and Jarrett Mees also had to work his way up through traffic for the win. In Lauren's second race, she high-sided and broke her finger in the crash. But that didn't keep this young lady down. She bravely mounted back up and went on to win her race. No wonder she's the crowd's favorite. Now it was time for the grand finale, the pro main event, that had Stevie Bonzi sitting on the pole with national rider Steve Murray next to him and Jam and Jarrett Mees sitting third off the pole. Stevie got the whole shot, Murray was second, and Jarrett came off third, but a crash caused a restart. Which was a carbon copy of the first, with Stevie getting the whole shot, Murray was second, and Jarrett was third. Another crash caused another restart. And would you believe it, it was another carbon copy of the first two starts. But this one was a clean start, and they were off and running. With Stevie in front, Murray in second, and Jarrett in third. On the second lap, Jarrett worked his way past Murray. And then Stevie for the lead, which Jarrett kept to the finish. So what'd you think about Jarrett, and how'd you like racing against him?
It was great. I mean, fast, extremely fast, straight out rode me, but oh well. That's always been my dream, to race with the GNC riders, and it finally came true. It was cool riding with Jarrett. He's a great guy on and off the track. I mean, he got a great personality, talks to everybody, always got a smile on his face. I mean, fast rider. Yeah, Jarrett's a cool guy. Great.
Jarrett said that he had a lot of fun racing against Stevie, and that he was a talented young rider and a great guy off the track, who he looked forward to doing battle with in the near future and for years to come.
Jarrett, you have fun.
Oh, it was a blast, you know, short tracking this tight, bumping and grinding. We didn't have many short tracks on the GNC circuit this year, so to come out here and support the West Coast and Eddie and Digger, it was just so cool. You know, I called up, actually Steve Murray called talking to me about the race last Sunday, and the money they were paying, and I love coming out west, love California. I said, man, I got to go.
We love having you, buddy. Ladies and gentlemen, this, I believe you're what, fourth or fifth in national points?
Fourth. I finished the year up in fourth. We were in third, 8 points out of second, looking pretty good, but we had some bike problems and stuff a couple weeks ago. So that's racing. We're still young, and you know, getting rookie of the year last year and winning two nationals this year, it was just awesome. And really got to thank all you fans and Saddleman Racing, Lance Harley Davidson, Mike Bell, and Eddie Mulder, Motion Pro, K&N, and Digger Helm for all their support.
Jarrett Mees, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for coming.
Good job, buddy. Good job.
After Bakersfield, we headed up to Salinas, California to hook up with future racing superstars Lauren Wallace and Stevie Bonzi. We got there just in time to catch up with Stevie and his dad, Steve, and to follow him over to their practice track at Lauren's house. When we got there, Lauren's dad was prepping the track. Lauren was already warming up her bike and waiting for Stevie to get suited up. And when he did, the race was on. It's no wonder these two are so good.
Hi, my name's Lauren Wallace.
How old are you?
I'm 14.
How long have you been racing for?
For about 10 years.
How did you get into racing?
From my dad. Ever since I was pretty much born, my dad just got me into this sport.
What do you like the most about the sport?
I like how it's real fast, and I just like to go ride.
Who do you look up to?
Pretty much Chris Carr, Johnny Murphy, Stevie Bonzi.
Stevie who?
Stevie Bonzi.
I'm just kidding. Have you ever been hurt racing?
Yeah, I had a lacerated liver, punctured lungs, and broke my leg. And, well, I'm not really scared no more because I went back to the track.
What are your goals?
I'd like to come number one and go as far as I can. Oh, I just like to race and just model and do some neat things like that on my basically side job or something.
How long have you wanted to model for?
Well, I've always wanted to model, and I don't know, I just thought that'd be cool to model for gear or something like that.
Did you race against Jarrett Mees in the pro class?
Yes, I raced against him in the pro class, and it's pretty fast, but hopefully one of these days I can get faster than him.
How'd you do at Bakersfield?
Bakersfield, I went real good. I won my heat races, and in the pro class, they came in third overall, and then I did crash, and I fractured my pinky, and then I got back up, and I took seventh overall.
Do your parents get nervous when you race?
My mom gets pretty nervous. My dad does, too, just a little bit, but they know I'm safe out there.
My name's Trish Wallace. I'm Lauren's mother.
So what do you think about Lauren racing?
I think it's awesome. I mean, there's not very many girls that are out there doing the sport, so, you know.
Do you get nervous when she races?
I'm very nervous. I'm just constantly praying that she comes off the track, and I don't breathe until she's off the track and all the races are over. And once she does that, then I'm happy with it.
So what do you see in the future for?
I see her being the first Mrs. Horizon, being the first girl to win the Horizon Award. And hopefully we can do that next year. So this was our first year to go back to the Nationals at Springfield, and she learned a lot, and she ranked 13th, which is not too bad. So next year I see her hopefully being a contender in the Horizon, if not winning it. After that, if it was up to me, I would have her in school and college and doing something safe. But if you ask her, she says she wants to do this as a career. And also, she wants to do some modeling. So we'll see how that all works out. We can do both, I guess, you know, with the motorcycle apparel. If we can tie it all in together, that'd be awesome.
How did she get into racing in the first place?
She was 2 years old, and my husband said that he wanted to get her a motorcycle, and I thought, well, that's fine. It'll sit in my garage for at least a few years anyways. What two-year-old can ride a bike? As soon as he brought it home, she opened it up on Christmas morning. The first thing she did was went out there and tried to start it, so I knew I had a racer on my hands. And after that, it's been nonstop since. She hasn't got off that bike. She started racing at 4 years old, so. Not too many people at 14 can say they have 10 years of racing experience.
My name is Jim Wallace, Springs, California.
Lauren's dad?
Lauren's dad, so everybody knows me.
Do you get worried when she races?
I used to, and then I kind of got used to it until she got into the big bikes, and then started all over again.
Did she do the amateur nationals this year?
Yeah, we went back to Washington and did the Northwest, and she got third up there overall, and then she came to the Springfield, and we ended up 13th in the nation up there. That was pretty good.
How long have you guys had your track for?
The track's been here. I made it when I was a kid, and we got the neighbors all broke in and everything, so they're all cool with it. And we just come out here and ride, and the track's been here, and it just keeps getting better as time goes on.
Go ahead and tell me who painted it.
This is a Shoei helmet painted by Aaron Hagar. And
who's he?
Aaron's Sammy Hagar's son, lives here in Monterey. And actually now he's working down there at the Cobble Wobble in Tahoe. His dad's restaurant, but he's a really good artist. He's really good.
And he's your wife's cousin?
Yeah.
Show me the dings in it.
Yeah, this is this right here is from the last step, Bakersfield. She got taken off her bike in the heat race, but a good thing for helmets, huh?
Yeah, it is.
I'm Stevie Bonzi. I'm 15 years old. I've been racing for about 10 years.
How did you get into racing?
My dad used to race a long time ago, and he just got me into it. And I mean, he never really made it too far. He went to about junior.
So you did the amateur nationals this year?
Yeah, we went back to Springfield, Illinois for the Grand National Champion for the amateur stuff. And I got a number one on the 254 stroke and number one on the 454 stroke. And I ended up, what I was going there mainly for was that Horizon Award, because, I mean, that gets a lot of recognition and all that. And it's an award that they give out, like, once a year to every sport, like motocross, road racing, and flat track, and I mean, it's a lot of work to get it, for sure.
Have you ever been hurt racing?
Not too many serious injuries. I've just cut up here and there, and I just fractured my clavicle and my tibia about a month ago at Lodi.
Have you always known that you wanted to race professional?
Yeah, since I first started, I knew I wanted to race. My goal was to be out there with Chris Carr and those guys, I mean, so hopefully it'll come true.
You think your parents get nervous when you race?
My dad, not too bad. My mom, she gets really nervous. She likes to come watch me race, but it's hard for her to watch me race. I don't know, it's real hard on her.
Hi, I'm Steve Bonzi. We're at the Wallaces in Salinas, California, at Lauren and Stevie's test track.
How'd Stevie get into racing?
He used to sit and watch tapes when he was really little. He'd sit right in front of the TV and watch old tapes of Monterey Short Track, and he loved bikes, and a little three-wheeler he used to slide around the driveway, wait for me to get home, put tires down, and sit there and watch him go around and around. And I kind of knew he wanted to race.
Do you get nervous when he races?
Just about every time. It gets a little intense, more at some tracks, you know, when there's some top riders and stuff.
Well, the future sure looks bright for these two young racers, and boy, are they exciting to watch race. In the Future is our segment where we spotlight future extreme stars, such as 9-year-old Devin from Orange County, who has been skating ever since he learned how to walk. Looks like we're out of time on this show, so I want to thank you for tuning in, and I hope you enjoyed yourself. Until next time, remember, Eye on Extreme is the show that keeps its eye on the extreme.
Too cold.